everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to learn about the triangle inequality theorem and some ways that it can be useful. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to use the triangle inequality theorem to determine when side lengths can form a triangle. First, we'll relate the triangle inequality theorem to the segment addition postulate. Next, we'll complete an example determining whether given lengths can form a triangle. Finally, we'll complete an example finding all possibilities for an unknown side length. Do you remember the segment addition postulate from a few units back? It says that given a line segment with endpoints A and C, point B lies on the segment if and only if AB plus BC equals AC. Do you remember how we moved point B off of segment AC, and then these numbers would no longer be true? Like this? If point B moves off of segment AC, then these numbers no longer make sense. And remember how our equal sign changed to an inequality instead? This, my friends, is where the triangle inequality theorem comes from. The triangle inequality theorem states that the sum of the lengths of any two sides of a triangle must be greater than the length of the third side. This means the same inequality holds for any two sides of a triangle. Sides BC and CA have to add to be greater than AB. And sides CA and AB must add to be more than side BC. But let's shorten this a little by labeling the sides. Then our labels and our inequalities can be shortened too. This is the triangle inequality theorem. We're going to learn how to use this theorem in a moment, so pause the video now if you need any time to catch up in your notes template and get ready. Here's our first example. It says, given the following lengths, can a triangle be formed? Let's start with part A. We have three side lengths here. Do you think they could form a triangle? And if so, how do you know? Did you use 5.2 as A, 4.4 as B, and 7.1 as C, and make the same three inequalities we just saw a moment ago? Or did you just make every combination you could by adding two sides and setting it greater than the third side? If we place the lengths into our inequalities, we can see if they're true statements. And it doesn't matter which order you substituted your values in, you'll still get the same three statements as me. And look at that. These are all true statements. No matter which two side lengths we add together, the result was always greater than the third side. So we know that a triangle can be formed. Let's move on to part B. Do you think these sides can form a triangle? And if so, how do you know? Let's make three inequalities again. Do any two sides always add up to be more than the third side? No, one of these isn't true. 3 plus 6 is not greater than 9, it's exactly equal to 9. So we cannot make a triangle from these lengths. What about part C? Calculate whether or not these sides can form a triangle. Let's use the triangle inequality theorem again to form three inequalities. Are these all true? Well, 4.1 plus 7.4 is 11.5. That's not greater than 11.6, so the second statement is false. We cannot make a triangle with these side lengths. Our second example says, given a triangle with side lengths 5 and 14, what are all the possible lengths of X, the third side? Can you make the same three inequalities you're used to making using 5, 14, and X as the side lengths? Try it now. Did you come up with these? Yours may be in a different order, but that doesn't matter. Now I have a big question for you. We know that X represents a side of the triangle, which means it has to be a positive number. So which of these inequalities would be true no matter what positive number X is? This one. 14 plus any positive number will always be bigger than 5. Since this will always be true, we don't need to worry about finding specific X values for it. So let's just focus on the other two inequalities and see what X values will make them true. This first inequality is set up pretty perfectly already. 5 and 14 add to be 19, so this says 19 is greater than X, which is the same as saying X is less than 19. The second inequality needs a little rearranging. How can we get X alone on one side of this inequality? Hopefully, you said to subtract 5 on both sides, which gives us that X is greater than 9. Let's put those two statements together to write a single inequality showing everything X can be. We have that X is bigger than 9, but smaller than 19. Okay, so that may have seemed like a lot to take in. The goal was to give you some background information about why our answer turned out this way. But there is a shortcut we can use to get this answer. Do you notice a relationship between these side lengths and the numbers we got here? Adding 5 and 14 gives us 19. And subtracting the smaller side, 5, from the larger side, 14, gives us 9. That's the shortcut. We subtract the side lengths, put a less than symbol, write whatever variable represents the missing side, put another less than symbol, and then add the side lengths. Here, we have our final answer, and a shortcut for getting there. Pause the video now so you can catch up on your notes, and go back to rewatch anything you need to. Great job with your note-taking. Now you can use the triangle inequality theorem to verify whether or not three side lengths can form a triangle. And use a shortcut that came directly from the triangle inequality theorem to find all possible lengths of a missing side. See you next time! Hey.